In just hours, the valley will be haunted by little ghosts and goblins, and parents want to make sure their kids have a safe holiday.
Welcome, foolish mortals. I am your host, your ghost host.
This is our ghost host. I built him in 2003. He's basically a plastic skull with some hobby servos in there to give him movement. On top of this skull, I glued this mask, a rubber mask that I got from Party City, a few bucks. These are the little servos like you have in remote control cars. And back here as well, he has four of them. This one controls side to side, this is forward and back. This one controls the eyes, and for the mouth.
Lorraine, the streets are quiet now, but the excitement for Halloween is definitely growing, as you can tell from this incredible haunted house in Henderson. It took the owners 3 months to put all this together, and apparently they do this every single year. Now, you know there will definitely be lots of trick-or-treaters here tomorrow night, but tonight, some helpful tips from a local family before your children head out. Lorraine, check this out. Yeah, it is very scary out here. Now, parents, your best bet in making sure your children are safe is to go with them trick-or-treating and just teaching them basic everyday safety tips, such as not getting in a car with strangers or looking both ways before crossing the street.
Parents and kids are gearing up for Halloween tomorrow. Families are busy preparing their costumes for a night of trick-or-treating, but there are some things that you should be aware of to make sure the night will be a safe one. Eyewitness News reporter Adrian Ramblo joins us live from Henderson with a story. Adrian?
Colleen, it should be a great night for the kids tomorrow night, and here's the reason why. They're going to be able to trick-or-treat at home just like this one. This is an award winner. You can see the front lawn is decorated like a cemetery. The ghosts in the windows over there. There's a massive spider web with spiders coming down from the trees, fog machine, sound effects, the works. And while tomorrow night is all about fun, parents should be aware of some safety concerns, including traffic safety and the presence of sexual predators. Sometimes sexual predators know their victims. It's not a case of a complete stranger going out and committing the crime, which is why authorities suggest that parents or teenagers always accompany trick-or-treaters. Reporting live, I'm Adrian Arambulo, Channel 8 Eyewitness News.
That ghost just keeps on popping up. Thanks, Adrian.
We control our movement with compressed air. The compressed air shoots into a cylinder like this. We shoot it in, the rod comes out, we put the air in the other inlet, and it goes back in. We use this for Fifi the dog, Papa Ghoulie, and some of our other effects.
Eyewitness News reporter Adrian Ramblo joins us live from a haunted house in Henderson with a closer look on Halloween safety. Adrian?
Colleen, tomorrow is going to be a big day for thousands of Valley children. They're going to be out trick-or-treating. If they're lucky, they're going to find a place like this. This is an award winner, and you can simply see why. Front yard decorated like a cemetery. You can see the spiders crawling down the trees, the spider webs, and even the ghost way upstairs. And while the children are going to be focused on the fun, there's some steps parents can take to ensure this Halloween will be a safe one.
No, I mean, it's a good signal. I was trying to get a better. I mean, you're at 30. There's only 10 more points you can go.
Countdown to Halloween is on. This is where we're going to go. I'm Adrian Moran from Channel 8.
time to come off the sugar high. Halloween is just about over. Photojournalist Roger Briner takes us to the scary sights and sounds of Las Vegas on Halloween.
Great experience. I loved it as a kid. I love the costumes, everything that the kids do. It's really all about the
candy.
I got Hershey's.
Tootsie what?
Anything chocolate.
I just kind of started, so I don't have that much.
We used to carry pillowcases. Now the kids just carry small little containers.
You have enough candy?
Oh, I have plenty of candy.
I like the different costumes.
We love to get dressed up, and we had a blast.
Trick or treat.
Let's cross the street.
Cross the street.
You got too much candy, you gotta do this.
Sorting out the candy, that's always a huge thing every year.
And how long are you gonna have your candy afterwards?
I don't know.
2 days?
Within a week or so.
Unless my mom lets me eat it all in the night.
Go, go, go!
I think it's just as exciting today as it was when I was a kid.
This holiday has become unreal.
Halloween here since we moved into the house back in 96, and every year we add a little bit more. I started experimenting with pneumatics and pop-up stuff and adding some sound, and it's really gotten crazy. We've had a lot of fun. Since the kids were born, we've had even more fun with the kids getting into it. And starting in about, I think it was 2001, we did the gates, and then we started adding more and more moving stuff, and since then it's really gotten out of control. But we really love it.
When hinges creak in doorless chambers, and strange and frightening sounds echo through the halls, whenever candlelights flicker where the air is deathly still, that is the time when ghosts are present, practicing their terror with ghoulish delight. Welcome, foolish mortals, to the Haunted Mansion. I am your host, your ghost host.
Be sure to bring your death certificate if you decide to join us.